And now to the second day of President Trump's state visit to Japan. He and the First Lady accompanying Prime Minister Shinzo Abe and his wife to the Sumo Grand Championship in Tokyo. They all sat ringside together there. Take a look.
I think it's the first time there's been a sumo match on this show. I think this has made history.
It might be. What a thing to wake up to, right?
Right. President Trump presented this huge trophy, the President's Cup, to the winner. A trophy so big, you have to be a sumo wrestler to lift it almost. But the President later said that he bought that beautiful trophy, and he hopes it continues to be awarded for many hundreds of years, he said.
All right.
CNN's Boris Sanchez is traveling with the president, joins us live from Tokyo. Busy day for the president and for the prime minister. What else do they have coming up?
That's right, Victor and Christia. A busy day of bonding for the two leaders. They just turned in for the evening, finishing a hibachi-style dinner featuring Wagyu beef and grilled chicken alongside their two partners. Previously, the president was at that sumo tournament. He got a warm reception there, handing over the President's Cup, this almost 4 foot, 70 pound trophy, over to the grand champion. The president saying that he had always wanted to see a sumo tournament in person. He told reporters at dinner that he was having a great time. He and Shinzo Abe had hit the links this morning, playing golf together, something that they frequently do when they meet. We should point out, though, there is some daylight between these two leaders on key issues, including security. And that came to the forefront after the president tweeted this out about North Korea earlier in the day. The president writing, quote, "North Korea fired off some small weapons which disturbed some of my people and others, but not me. I have confidence that Chairman Kim will keep his promise to me." The president then goes on to attack former Vice President Joe Biden and current presidential candidate. We won't get into that, but we should point out that the Japanese are uneasy about this relationship between President Trump and Chairman Kim. They have correctly pointed out, as has the president's national security director, Ambassador John Bolton, that North Korea violated UN resolutions by testing those short-range ballistic missiles last month. So some daylight there between the president and Abe. Also on trade, the two sides are still far apart in a potential bilateral trade deal. The president tweeting out that he expected that the deal will likely come at some point after July, after there are elections here in Japan. The president also talked about the main event coming tomorrow when he meets the new Emperor Naruhito. This is really a big deal for the two nations, something that the president is looking forward to, and that underscores the importance of the relationship between these two world powers. Victor and Christie.